it's hard to make that argument because, you know, in some of these products, we can be competitive as long as it's level playing field. Is that those countries then turn around and take it out on Joe and Fred and others who are trying to export stuff. Because, you know, if we raise our tariffs without it being unfair, they're going to do the same. That's when you get into a little bit of what they call the trade war, which is going to be bad for Canada and us if we do that. I think probably it's a negotiating position today that the president's saying, okay, June 1st is coming, we're going to go ahead and push these tariffs on Mexico and Canada, even though we've got these NAFTA negotiations. I think they frankly didn't feel like those countries probably had responded as much as they should have to the negotiation. So I'm hopeful it will work out over time, that they'll come up with some solution that's a good compromise. But it's risky strategy. So I'm all for enforcement. I think my record stands on that, but I am worried about an escalating tariff war, right? I mean, tariffs are taxes. And so we pay more as consumers, and that's appropriate if we're trying to protect an industry that should be protected, like the steel industry, if someone is cheating. Because we want to have a steel industry in this country. It's very important. Ohio is very important. But if it's not on that basis, then it actually ends up costing more for everything.
Senator Portman, what's your response to the announcement by the by President Trump's administration on the tariffs action against Canada, European Union, and Mexico today?
I hope we can work something out, because the problem of increasing tariffs on countries that are not unfairly trading is that they may raise their tariffs on our products. And Canada in particular is a huge trading partner of Ohio. We send half of our exports in Ohio to two countries, Canada and Mexico, and Canada is the biggest. So we got to be careful that we don't enter into a trade war. On the other hand, we got to be sure that steel is fairly traded, and I've taken a lead on that, cutting back on the Chinese exports particularly because they were selling them here in this country for below their cost, which is dumping, and also subsidizing their product, which is not legal. So we need to be tougher on pushing back on the people that are, you know, not following the laws, not following the rules. And yet we got to be careful on countries like Canada. We actually send more steel to Canada than they send to us, and we're not accusing them of doing anything unfair. So I think we got to be cautious, because we don't want to start a trade war. There's a law called 232, Section 232 of the Trade Act, and under 232, an administration is permitted to raise the tariffs on products for national security concerns. It was written back in the 1960s, and it's only been used, hasn't been used since the 1970s. So I don't object to the law. I think that, you know, other administrations have used it more judiciously. Now, I have said from the start that the countries and products where you have a lot of imports coming in very high levels and where there's a national security concern, like electrical steel, where we only have one manufacturer in the United States of electrical steel, and you have a 100% increase of imports coming in last year, that is a national security concern. As to specific countries, as to specific products, I think in a more targeted way we should do this. But as to Canada, as an example, I think it's a problem. Well, it's not since the 70s has an administration used Section 232, and we just need to use it judiciously. I'm not saying we shouldn't use it, but let's be sure it's focused on the right products and the right